This is the only video you're going to need to withdraw and cash out your Bitcoin into your bank account as cold hard cash. Step 1. Get your Bitcoin into an exchange if it's not already there. If it is, great, just use the timestamps below to skip directly to step 2. If your Bitcoin is held outside of an exchange, such as on your Trust Wallet app, Ledger Live if you've got a Ledger Nano device, or Trezor Safe and the Trezor Suite where my Bitcoin is currently held, and I'm going to use that as this demonstration, then you're going to need step 1. An exchange such as Coinbase, Binance, Kraken, or KuCoin. Why is that? Because the exchange will then allow you to connect to your bank account in the last step, which is the step most people stuff up. So watch till the end. So firstly, to get your Bitcoin into your exchange, you need to log into the software. So in my instance, I'm using Trezor Suite. What I'm going to do here in this step is send my Bitcoin from my Trezor, so from my hardware wallet account, I'm going to send it and I'm going to then receive it into my exchange account. So if you haven't already got an exchange, Coinbase is probably the most widely used, followed by Kraken and Binance. So in your exchange, you want to receive crypto, but I'm just going to go to Bitcoin first. I want to receive crypto, I want to receive Bitcoin through the Bitcoin network, and that's going to display your receive address. Let's copy that receive address. Done. Now, into our hardware wallet platform, I need to go to send because I want to send the Bitcoin that exists here. And I'm then going to paste the receive address I just copied from my exchange. Enter the amount of Bitcoin you want to send. Okay. I like to leave everything else as default. I'm then going to review and send. As you can see here, it's asking me to verify that the address that I see on the screen is what I'm seeing on the device. So let me just continue that. It's asking me to confirm the amount of Bitcoin I want to send. So I'll confirm. I've signed the transaction, which now enables the send button here. So I'll now click send, and as you can see, the expected wait time is around 20 minutes today. Okay, the send has begun, and you should be able to see the transaction in the history. It will come up as pending until it's completed. So now I'm going to wait the 20 minutes and then refresh my exchange account, where I will have received the Bitcoin. I've waited and I can see the Bitcoin that I've sent has now arrived successfully. So that's step 1 completed. Step 2, let's sell our Bitcoin for currency. So we've gone to sell, we want to sell our Bitcoin and we want to sell it to currency. Now mine's obviously showing Australian dollars, yours should show your particular currency. Enter the amount of Bitcoin that you want to sell, either in Bitcoin or dollars. Let's review the order. And when you're ready, you can sell that for currency. And that's done. That's instantaneous. That's step 2 complete. Now we'll make sure that our exchange is set up to make withdrawals. So in your exchange, look for the withdrawal link. So withdraw cash. Here's the part that catches people out. If your exchange doesn't allow you to actually make the withdrawal, that's because your bank account is not connected yet to the exchange. To connect your bank account, unfortunately, is you must make a deposit first. by making a deposit, even if it's $5 or $10 to your exchange, what that does is act as a way of validating your bank account and therefore enable you to make a withdrawal. If you haven't done that, you won't be able to make the withdrawal. And if you have done that, you should be able to see your bank account come up as an option for the instant cash out. So I'm going to pick the account that I want to cash out to and continue. The fee in this instance is nil. You can cash out. Okay, the request is sent. Cash has landed in my bank account, and that was done instantaneously with Coinbase because I've had previous transaction history with them.